got a remedy for all of y'all. It's called the cross.
Can we do the same thing when we start, say, if I plant a seed, it doesn't come up, first person I'm gonna blame is the person that came in the seed.
Got the ground or somebody? The ground, the wind, the rain, something going on, other than me. Fertilizer, yeah, it wasn't no good. Wind, the rain, the sun, something didn't go the way, it wasn't me. When God brings judgment, he's gonna account for it. Something about that seed wasn't no good. Something about when you planted it, maybe that was it, when you planted it. Can't plant in winter. Some folks are trying. Don't work! It didn't work!
Nice.
I'm planning to win.
The greenhouse, gotta get the greenhouse effect and all this. Yeah. So I'm blaming on something. God's gonna, accountability. When did you plant that thing? Okay, now, verse 7. Which keepeth judgment for the oppressed, this is important, which executed judgment for the oppressed, he gives what?
Food to the hungry.
Yes. He loses the prison. So there's nothing like being in prison, you know, for something that you didn't do. Unjust. See, he don't want nobody punished when they should not be punished. But if you leave it to man, with his limited abilities, he will do that. He will do that. When example as Joseph. God didn't like that. He didn't like Joseph down in that dungeon like that. Was not God's perfect plan for Joseph. He could preach from here to yonder, but I can tell you that was not God's perfect plan for Joseph. Joseph said, God, turn it around to my good. You meant it for good. I mean, you meant it for evil. God turned it around for my good, but it was not God's plan for me to be sold into slavery and spend all those years in that dungeon down there in Egypt, in Pharaoh's house. That was not God's plan for my life. Cool. That was not God's plan for my life. Mashed potatoes behind. I'm doing all now. And they're preaching no truth. So, that it is not God's will for people to be oppressed. So he will come in an unjust situation and get it right. The woman at the well again. He'll come in and get it right. And he gives food to the hungry. The Lord loosened the prisoners. Okay, he didn't want that to happen. Okay, Isaiah 42, 1 through 9. Let's see if we can get that right. Isaiah 42, 1 through 9. Damn, that's a lot of reading. Let's see here. I'll go with verse Isaiah 42, and let's pick it up to verse 4. The first two verses there is showing that God, it's a foreshadow of Jesus. And I'll pick it up in verse 4. You shall not fall nor be discouraged till he have set judgment in the earth, and the islands should wait for his law. Thus said God the Lord, he that created the heavens, stretched them out, spread forth the earth, that which cometh out of it, he giveth bread unto the people upon it, and spirit to them that walk therein. I, the Lord, have called thee in righteousness, and will hold thine hand, will keep thee, and give thee a covenant of the people, alike to the Gentiles, to open the blind eyes. Now, question for the class. How can Isaiah say that? Has Isaiah ever seen the Lord open a blind eye? Never up until Jesus walked the earth, had a blinded eye been opened. Isaiah can prophesy. To open the blind eyes, to bring out the prisoners from the prison, and them that sit in darkness out of the prison house. So Isaiah saw the injustice of mankind, and he says, the day is going to come when the Lord is going to let those innocent people out of jail. He's going to minister justice and fairness to people. Okay, I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Behold, the former things are come to pass, new things do I declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them. So this is Isaiah's prophesying, and he says, I'm telling you about the future. The Lord, that's why the verse 1 and 2 is a foreshadow of the Lord, Jesus Christ, of the Messiah. Isaiah said, it's going to happen. Because right now, how many of you know people in jail should not be there? Didn't get the right sentence. Not fair. Yeah. The way it went. It's still in there. Man don't care.
Yeah.
It's still in there.
So do you think that we were used to kill Saddam Hussein because of the fact that he had people in prison?
Yeah, but who knows how God, you know, you got to really, study how the Lord brought that thing around, you know, in the affairs of man. And we know the history of Saddam, it wasn't no good. He did a whole bunch of bad stuff. You know, these tyrants across the world. And all of a sudden, you see the kingdoms, one after another, fall. And are we living in end times where the Lord is showing that these things is going to fall? I am the Lord. He said that about Pharaoh. I set you up to show my power.
Yeah.
You know, Pharaoh thought he was a lame dog. Who is the Lord that I should obey him? Who is that? Moses is trying to tell him. Who's the Lord? Who are you talking about? Yeah. And God says, well, Pharaoh, this is why I set you up. You know, you had the opportunity to walk with me, but you wanted to be Mr. Big Doll all on your own. Now I'm going to show you who's really the top person, the top one around. You know, so Pharaoh lost his stuff, lost all that production from the children of Israel, lost his economy. Saddam Hussein got all that oil and all that stuff over there, building Syria now. Got all that wealth of resources over there. Kingdoms falling on top. What's going on? I think some justice and judgment is happening in the earth. We can't see how it's, well, you know, add it all up, but man, it sure looks like in the final analysis, you're gone, Mr. Tyrant. All that oil and stuff, oil revenue, money in the banks all across the world, you can't even get now. What's up with that? They're closing the banks on you. You can't even get your own money. Talking about judgment.
Wicked.
The wicked one do what? Destroy themselves.
Yep. Agreed.
You don't have to come down here and wipe them out there. Destroy themselves. Call stuff down
there. Yeah.
To knock them off. Right. So, now let me go to verse 8. The Lord opened the eyes of the blind. The Lord raised them up that are bowed down. The Lord loveth the righteous. The Lord preserveth the strangers. He relieved the fatherless and widow. But the way of the wicked, he does what? He turns it upside down. The Lord shall reign forever, even thy God, O Zion, unto all what? So his justice has been administered to every generation. New Testament, Old Testament, in terms, his justice is being administered. He's a God of justice, and he's a God of compassion. He's also a God of accountability. But he can do all of that in one sweep. Lord, we would have been consumed if it wasn't for your mercy. We've been right back. Yeah, we were surely guilty. Israel was like that a lot of times. Lord, we was guilty. We went into those other nations. set up pagan gods, we did all this and all that. We shouldn't, you should have just, you know, we was, could have been just wiped out. But it wasn't for your mercy. Hello? Hold your hand up. Hello? But if it wasn't for your mercy and your grace, I'd have been gone a long time ago. That's just the way it is. So he has a cross to pay for the sin, if you would accept that remedy. Our folks won't accept that remedy. I'm pretty sure they had taken the thorn to the curb. Stone that the builders rejected. Mm-hmm. Now that ain't the answer. Throw away the cornerstone, the chief cornerstone. Yeah, you built it. Romans 3 says so that all the world can, he can say to everybody, you guilty. not one innocent. No, not one. All guilty before God. Bring the justice, bring some mercy. Mercy triumphs, rejoice over the judgment and justice. Mercy can get a shot, just take it. But you may have to account for that. Sure you would. That's called repentance. Mercy will come in and lift you up. Because you have to show that he's a just God. The lady, no, she's supposed to be at home and be stoned. But that's some justice. What's that? That's some mercy. What's that? You who without sin, throw the first stone.
Lamentations, where it says, that's where it says, it is of the Lord's mercies that we're not consumed, mm-hmm. because his compassion fail not. Mm-hmm. That's in verse 22, but in verse 32 it says, but though he cause grief, yet will he have compassion according to the multitude of his mercies.
Multitude of mercies. He has lots of mercy. He can apply to lots of. He's not going to run out of mercy. Yeah, you might be a bad ass in the whole thing. I don't know how they're going to show mercy to this guy in Colorado. Why? Because I'm limited. Yeah. Sister Shirley said,
crying.
That's deep.